Liberty Nation with Tim Donner.
There is no way to understate the effect of social media censorship of conservatives who are now attempting to fight back and hold Facebook, Google, Twitter, and others accountable. And as we bring back Brent Bozell, the founder and president of the Media Research Center and the nation's leading media watchdog, he says we need to understand that a majority of the social media shutdown of conservatives comes from a bias not of commission, but omission.
The bias by omission with the censorship by omission against conservatives is concerned you don't see it happen. Let me give you an example. If you go on the Google search engine searching for something, by definition, you are ignorant of that subject, on that subject, else you would not have gone on Google. You were going there to learn about the subject. If you key in topic X and you see on the front page, which, by the way, overwhelmingly, people go, 97% of the people stop at the first page because right. They get the information they wanted. And if you see that information that you wanted is such that you accept it, but you don't know that A, it's a far left interpretation of the issue, and B, the conservative side of it has either been defanged or in defamed, one or the other. If you are unaware of that sort, you'll never know what it was that hit you, which is why studies have been done. This Professor Robert Epstein did a study a couple of years ago that found that just by manipulating that front page, you know, Google says it can't manipulate algorithms. Nonsense. Of course it can.
Of course they can.
But by manipulating those algorithms, you could actually, by manipulating just that page, you could sway 20% of the undecided voters in any election.
Well, the other day I went and looked up Ukraine Biden on a Google search, and it took me till the third page to find a story that was actually about Biden and Hunter Biden and their activity in Ukraine. Now, Brent...
But Tim, the point was, you're knowledgeable because you live and breathe this sort of thing. And this is not a knock.
Right.
95% of Americans aren't. You know, they worry about other things in their lives.
Right.
So they rely on this, just like they rely on the CBS Evening News, to be honest, with their report. So when they have manipulated that data, so you saw just what you reported, well, what happens? It moves the voter perspective against the president, and it does exactly what this liberal professor, I might add, who, by the way, has done another study, and now he's pushing the numbers up to 30 and 40%.
I believe it. But it also seems, Brent, like not everyone in the conservative movement's completely on board in recognizing this censorship threat. Are you finding it relatively easy or difficult to find allies willing to expose this kind of censorship and fight against it?
It's so uncanny, the parallels between what we're trying to do now with social media, with what we did when we opened the doors of the Media Research Center 32 years ago. When we began, you had the overwhelming amount of Americans believed there was no such thing as a bias in the media. When we began, we had nothing going up against a multi-billion-dollar institution. And when we began, people looked to us, those who did were concerned about it, looked to us to do something about this. Today, it's the same thing. You've got some people on the right have no concern about this. They haven't been shadow banned that they know of. You know, when you have four people who are shadow banned in the House, and they all happen to be conservative Republicans, three of the four of them being members of the Freedom Caucus, I don't know. I sense a little trend
there. Just a little bit.
But, if you don't know you've been shadow banned, you think your message is getting out, and it isn't. By definition, you don't know you've been shadow banned. So there are a lot of people who are just dismissing this because it hasn't happened to them. Even if it hasn't happened to them, that doesn't mean it's not happening. It just means they've dodged a bullet or they are irrelevant in the conversation.
That is L. Brent Bozell, ready to take up the fight against censorship of conservatives on social media.